Tonight, we come together as a community to hear the stories of our veterans and to think about how we can take care of the men and women who take care of us.
Dear Brian, they say that time heals all wounds. Well, not all wounds. The death of a child is something you never really get over. What I felt the day you died is just as sharp and raw today as it was that hot summer afternoon in 2001. I've simply grown used to the pain. Now, I'm not crazy about sharing my grief with strangers, but I feel very strongly that your story needs to be told. Why? Because your story is the same story as countless other veterans whose wounds are not visible. After the Civil War, they called it soldier's heart. Then came shell shock, combat fatigue, and today we call it PTSD. Doesn't matter what we call it, it's still devastating to the veterans and their families. Now, looking back, I'd like to think I was the perfect teenager. I could not possibly have been as difficult as you were, Brian. And when you decided to go into the military right out of high school, I really thought it would be good for you, dear. But you came back a changed man. At first, I thought it was just the excitement of coming home. But this was different. Something wasn't right. You had always been talkative as a child, but now you took talking to a whole new level. You would go days, and I mean days, without sleeping, pacing back and forth and back and forth, and then suddenly be in the depths of depression, so deep that I was worried you would take your own life. The rumor among your friends was that you had killed someone during combat. You did not want to talk about it. But through all that inner turmoil, you managed to pull yourself together and go back to school. You missed a lot of classes, but you were determined, and I am proud to say, you stayed on top of your studies. Soon it was the summer of 2001. Student teaching was going to start soon. And I bet I was worried about relapses. But you were so excited. You wanted so badly to be a teacher. And I knew you would be good. You would be the kind of teacher that students remembered years later as the one that got them excited about history or literature or writing. There is no doubt in my mind you would have made a difference. Unfortunately, you never got that chance. That hot summer night, your heart simply stopped beating. The coroner could not explain it, and there was absolutely no evidence of an overdose. Maybe it was the experimental drugs they had you on. Maybe not. I don't know, and I guess it doesn't really matter, does it? I just know we both lost the battle that day. Me, just trying to keep you alive, and you, struggling to maintain some quality of life.